before we jump into the message, the word today, I want to point to a few resources that we'd like to make available for our friends as they travel. It's the first one. I produce a podcast called Jesus Movement Now. It's a weekly episode to inspire and equip everyday Jesus followers to play their unique part. The rule of revival and salvation. What the United States did, and it really helped on thousands, tens of thousands of young people sleeping in the kingdom of God, have a different culture of drugs, sex, and free love, you know, more rock and roll. But today, God's doing it, it's out. And He's invited us to play our unique part. And so, we started this during the COVID crisis because I couldn't travel, you know, so it's like, you know, we still got to get a message out. And ironically, after a number of months doing this, we realized, I'm speaking to more people around the world than I ever have on a weekly basis. So God's breathing on this, and so in the first few months, you realize we've got not only the top 10% of most downloaded podcasts in the world,
wow.
And then just this last week, I noticed that we got to bump into the top 5%. It's really crazy. And so second resource is New Identity, 30 Days of Prayer for Spiritual Transformation. This is a devotional workbook on the topic of identity that I could say about three, four years ago. How many of you know the topic of identity? There's tremendous confusion around the topic of culture today. And a lot of confusion stems from the reality that we believe the cultural lie that identity is something we choose based on our desires, our felt needs, the lusts of our flesh. But in the kingdom of God, because of the death and resurrection of Jesus, identity is not something we choose. Identity is not what you receive. And there is so much freedom and healing and deliverance that occurs when we let the God who created us be the one who defines us.
Yeah.
And so you can put your hands on that in the foyer on the way out. If you don't have cash or a credit card or an old checkbook that you can't use, you can't afford that, it's on me. I want everyone to have a resource in hand that can help them grow and our life is a plainly prophetic truth about who we are in Christ. Well, I was last with you all in the fall of 2019, before the turn of the year that we all entered into the book of Revelation together. And so I was with you all in the fall of 2019. And I began to share with God's story about what people believe God wanted to do in Middle Tennessee to protect the next generation. I was in this prophetic storyline. God had given some friends of mine a few dreams. In fact, one of them was the one from the top writer who wrote, "You're worthy of it all." We sang that song this morning. And we were responding to the Lord, believing that what He said in these dreams is actually the word of the Lord. That every campus in Wellington County is open to us. And that the point is right now. We were charged with this dream of God on our hearts. And God began to build the team. And I told the story about our ministry connected with these high school kids who were really far from God, these rebellious, party kids who were hosting these large scale raids. This is wild party for high school kids gathering hundreds of students. And we've been in the business with these guys, a ministry and these guys in business, just gathering, hosting these parties. They're like, "He's trying to help out, but we did it, you know?" And so we're doing the business of trying to see here in the weekend before the tip off here in the morning call. I'm going to
Thank you. some of it is fine.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.